And we're back here at Live Now Broadcasting, live now on the show floor at NAB 2019. We're here at the ICANN booth with Kevin Liu. Kevin, thank you so much for talking to us today.
No problem.
So I've used ICANN products for a long time, and I'm a corporate videographer. You know, we do mostly corporate industrial work. And these monitors have been fantastic because they've been high quality, but not very expensive, you know, compared to some of the other ones. But when I look at some of the rigs I see here, these look like lenses that, you know, Peter Jackson, or screens that Peter Jackson would use, or you'd see at a TV studio. Right. Tell us about what you've got here at the show.
All right, so let's talk about first that this thing that's on. It's on a teleprompter. So from our setup right here, we have it, we call this our broadcast one. So we're aiming at this kind of setup where most broadcasters would do. This is a 17-inch high-bright monitor. So what that means, high-bright, it means that even if you're in the bright condition of the...
I just want to turn it a little bit so we can
see.
Yeah.
So even in the bright conditions, you can still see, like, if you have a studio light aiming right at it,
right.
Talent can still easily read off the teleprompter. And then next we have here, we have these Blitz systems, wireless, that go straight to the monitors that you can let the director or someone else view what you're recording.
Now, I know, let me stop you for a second. Wireless video is a bit of a black art, as we have come to find out, you know, with some of the wireless stuff we've been doing here at the show. But there's, you know, good ones and there's not so good ones. I know Teradek has a lot of ones that people have used. And you can also pay, it seems, like $200, $2,000, $20,000 for wireless systems. These wireless ones, what sort of range do you get? Who are they aimed at and what sort of price point do you have?
Yeah, we have the wireless system. We call them the Blitz. We have a 1500, which is $3,000.
1500 feet,
yes.
$3,000.
$3,000. Then we have a 600 feet one, which is $1,799. And then we have a 500 feet one that's released as new. It's more of a little more basic, so it's $1,399.
And are all these HDMI and SDI?
Yes, they're all HDMI and SDI, and they also cross-convert. So let's say you put in HDMI, you can SDI out, or vice versa.
Fantastic. So those I know are becoming really, really popular with folks. Keep going. Take us through the rest.
All right. So next thing you see here is we have this, what we call our PD Movie, which we actually distribute for them in the U.S. Basically, this allows you to control the focus, the iris, and the zoom all into this one system on a handle so that your whatever you're doing, that your camera operator can do it all by himself without worrying about anything. And then last but not least is our monitors. So this is a SX7, which is a $1,000 monitor. It's high bright. So $1,000 monitor, high bright, SDI and SDI, HDMI in and SDI. So this is really great for people who want to be outdoors.
And when you say high bright, how many nits?
2,000.
2,000 nits. That is, you go put sunglasses on to watch the monitor.
You probably could. You do that. This is basically for people who don't want to bother with sun hoods outdoors.
And this looks like, is that a 7-inch?
7-inch one.
But it looks super beefy. I mean, it's well-built aluminum. You got quarter 20s on the side here. So that's a camera that or a screen that, you know, can take road use easily.
Yes. And also, it's also metal because it helps distribute the heat. Because 2,000 nit does produce a lot of heat.
Right, right.
And that brings me into talking about its little brother, which we are coming. This is the one I'm really excited for. It is brand new at the show. First time being showed. There is not even released yet. It's the XSS5, which is basically the little brother. Almost identical, except that it is 5-inch, 2,000 nit as well. But the price point is very enticing at $399.
So for $399, you get a 5-inch monitor with 2,000 nits.
Yes.
SDI and HDMI?
SDI and HDMI. You do get SDI in and out, but you only get HDMI in, no HDMI out.
I see. So there's a loop through on the SDI, but
no, it doesn't. Loop through on SDI, but not on the HDMI.
Right. What about power options for this little guy?
Power option, it uses the Sony L-series style ones, kind of like the NPs, like 970s, 750s, and 550s.
That's got to be like the most popular battery.
Yeah, it's just something easy that most people have. You don't have to buy them. You already have them.
What when you buy a unit like this, does it come with a power adapter, charging case?
Usually when you buy something like this, it definitely comes with a DTAP cable. So you can always do it to a pro battery. And it also comes with a shoe mount, usually a horseshoe mount. And we are working on coming with a little piece that allows you to plug it into the wall as well, AC adapters, basically.
I notice you also have batteries here. Tell us a little bit about that.
We do actually sell pro batteries as well. This is a V-mount battery, which is very popular for people who run usually bigger cameras. And this one is nice that it's able to de-tap out, so it lasts out longer than those Sony DV batteries.
Right, you can take a SLR like you've got here,
yes,
probably run it all week on one of those.
Probably, not all week, but at least all day, for sure. From show in to show, yeah.
That would be great. Well, listen, Kevin, I want to thank you very much. It looks like teleprompters, screens, wireless transmission, lens controls, and batteries. I mean, what's the next step for ICANN? What part would you like to get into?
I'm not sure what next part, but we left out one of the biggest thing we do is lighting. Lighting is probably ICANN's bread and butter, actually. But right now, we're actually trying to focus mainly on our items that we are good at, and we want to get better at it.
Yeah, and these look great. These look like the KinoFlow LED, but I'm sure the price point isn't what a company like KinoFlow charges.
Yes, definitely not. They're not the price tag of nowhere near KinoFlow's.
Tell us a little bit about lights while we're here.
Let me point a little bit.
Sure.
So right up here, we have the... We have the LBX30. It is a bicolor light. Right now, we sell it for $15.99, so that's a very, very... attractive price point. And it's bicolor, meaning that you can do it with tungsten or daylight, anywhere in between the 56 and 32.
What sort of remote control options do you have for the lights?
It's used DMX only, yeah.
So it doesn't come with any kind of wireless remote?
No, it does not. Usually most for these lights, we kind of allow people to put them up like this on a truss and just leave it there and control with DMX.
Kevin, I think we've seen some wonderful things today. I want to thank you for joining us and taking us on a tour of your booth.
No problem. Thank you for having us.
And that's it for us right now, but we'll be back in 5 or 10 minutes with another wonderful interview live right here from the show floor of NAB 2019. So stick with us and join us next time on Live Now.